Now let's see about swing component J-text area control. J-text area control is mainly useful in order to create a multi-lane text box. Multi-lane text box means we can enter multiple lines of text. The best example for multi-lane text box is if we want to enter any address. So our name, our father name, door number, district, PIN number, state, country, like that, we need to specify several details in several rows. So in that occasion, we can use this multi-lane text box. So JText area class or control is mainly useful in order to create a multi-lane text box. Now let's see about the constructors of JText area class. The first constructor is JText area left parenthesis right parenthesis. It is an empty constructor. Here it is a class name. J, T and area are uppercase letters. Second constructor accepts a string as the argument. Third constructor accepts two integers as the argument. Fourth constructor accepts string, integer, integer as the argument. So we can use any of these constructor in order to create a multi-lane text box. Let's see about the first constructor. It is useful in order to create a multi-lane text box with no text. So initially nothing will be printed in the multi-lane text box. Second one, JText area of string text. It is useful in order to create a multi-lane text box with the specified text. Let us assume that within the double quotations here we entered welcome. So now initially welcome will be displayed in the text area control. Next one, we can specify two integer values. So the multi-lane text box will be created with the specified number of rows and the specified number of columns. Let us assume that we specify like this 30 comma 40. So here the text area control will be created with 30 rows. So this is nothing but rows value. Height, rows means height, and 40 columns. So 40 width. So width is nothing but 40. For 40 columns width and 30 rows height. Next one, if we use this constructor, then the text area control will be displayed with the default text. Here we have specified some text, so it will be displayed with the specified text and with the specified number of rows and with the specified number of columns, the corresponding text area control will be created. Now let's see about methods of the JText area class. Mainly we have 5 methods. The first method is void set font of font f. It is useful in order to specify the font. We have several font styles like Times New Roman, Arial, Sans Serif. Likewise, there are several font styles are there. If you want to set any font style for the corresponding text, we can make use of this method. Next one, get columns method. It is useful in order to return the number of columns that are in the multi-lane text box. Let the text box is created with 30 columns. Then get columns method will return 30 as the output. Get rows method. It is useful to return the number of rows of the corresponding text area control. Next one, set columns of integer call. So if you want to set a column width for the corresponding JText area control, then we can use the set columns. Set rows of int rows. So it is useful in order to set rows, number of rows for the text area control. Now let's see the program. Import space java x dot swing dot star semicolon. Here x stands for extension. So we have a parent package called java x package. In java x package we have a sub package called swing package. In swing package contains several classes like j frame class, j text area class and component class. So in this program we are using those three classes. That's why we imported swing package. Component classes contains methods like set bounds, yard, set size, set layout, set visible. These 5 methods are present in component class. Component class is present in the swing package. Next to public class text area demo. So text area demo left parenthesis right parenthesis. So this is nothing but the constructor. So first initially we have created the frame j frame f is equal to new j frame of what is the title here within the double quotations text area example. So this is nothing but our frame. So what is the title? Text area example. If you don't give any title, then no title will get printed. So text area example. So minus rectangle and cross mark will get printed. Next, J text area T is equal to new J text area. So that here by default a multi-line text box will be created here with default number of rows and default number of columns. Next, once a text area control is created, then where we have to add that control to the frame. For that we use a set bounds method. So T dot set bounds of this 10 is nothing but x coordinate, 30 means y coordinate, 100 means width, 70 means height. Let it be some that x coordinate and y coordinate value. So 100 means what? Width. So this is nothing but width. 70 means height. This is nothing but height. Next, once it is created, then we have to add that text area control to the frame. So that should be done with the help of this method, f dot add of t. Next, f dot set size of 300, 300. So what is the dimension of the frame? So the first 300 specifies width. So this is nothing but width, whereas the second 300 specifies height of the frame. Next one, f dot set layout of none. Here we are not using any layout manager. We have different types of layout managers like border layout, flow layout, grid layout, card layout. But in this program, we are not using any layout manager. So that's why we are using f dot set layout of none. It specifies that we are not using any layout manager. Next, initially the frame will be in invisible state. So if you want to make that frame as visible, then we have to use a set visible method. So f dot set visible of true. So whenever the statement is executed, then our frame will be in visible state. Next, this is nothing but end of the constructor. So we have closed the constructor here. Next, public static void main string args. Here from the main method we have to call the constructor. We know that whenever an object is created, then automatically the corresponding constructor will be called. But there is no need of that reference here. So that's why we have created only object. Reference is not created. If you want, we can create the object like text area demo obj is equal to new text area demo. But here obj, that reference is not needed. So that's why that is not placed here. New text area demo will create an object for the class. So whenever an object is created, then this constructor will get called and all the statements in the constructor will be executed. So this is nothing but end of the main method. This right curly brace is nothing but end of the class. Next, we have to compile the program. So Java C space text area demo dot Java. Next, we need to execute the program. So Java space text area demo. So for compilation, we use Java C. For execution, Java. So Java space text area demo dot Java. Here, this is frame program. So for executing this program, there is no need of any applet viewer. Simply by using Java command, we can run the program. So whenever we run the program, then we get an output like this. So this is about J text area control.